Hey everybody, Luis Perez here with a video tutorial focusing on the enhanced version of VoiceOver that ships with the fourth generation Apple TV. This version of VoiceOver is made possible by the touch area that's now available with the Siri remote that comes with this version of the Apple TV. This touch area allows you to perform a lot of the gestures that you may be familiar with if you've ever used VoiceOver on an iOS device or on a Mac with a trackpad. So having said that, let's go ahead and get started and take a look at VoiceOver on the fourth generation Apple TV. You can enable VoiceOver when you first set up your new Apple TV, and it will guide you through the setup process. You do this by triple-clicking the menu button on your Siri remote once you have your Apple TV connected and it's turned on. If your Apple TV has already been through the setup process, you can still enable VoiceOver by going into the settings. You'll begin by going into Settings. Then you'll choose General, followed by Accessibility, then scroll down and choose VoiceOver. Here you can turn VoiceOver on.
VoiceOver on, 1 of 2.
Once VoiceOver is turned on, you can also scroll down to choose VoiceOver Practice.
VoiceOver Practice, button, 2 of 2.
And if you select VoiceOver Practice,
VoiceOver Practice, Start VoiceOver Practice,
you can choose Start VoiceOver Practice.
VoiceOver Practice Active, 1 of 1.
When you do that, you can perform a number of different gestures and hear what they do with VoiceOver.
Flick right, move focus to the right, flick up, move focus up, flick down, move focus down.
When you're finished with the VoiceOver Practice, just press Menu on your remote.
VoiceOver. VoiceOver Practice. Button. 2 of 2.
And this will send you back to the VoiceOver pane. Here you can also adjust the speech rate.
Speech. Speech rate. Speech rate. Very slow. Button.
If you choose that option, you can go from very slow all the way up to very fast for the speech rate.
VoiceOver. Speech. Use pitch. Off. 2 of 2. On.
And you can also choose to change the pitch to indicate context. So this will change the pitch whenever you go back to a different menu or when you go into a menu. You don't always have to go into settings to turn VoiceOver on the long way. You can also use the accessibility shortcut, which is also available on iOS devices, to enable VoiceOver quickly by triple-clicking your menu button. To configure the accessibility shortcut, go into the accessibility pane, then scroll all the way down to the bottom, choose accessibility shortcut, and then in here, make sure VoiceOver is the only option that has the check mark on it. So now if I go to the home screen, I can triple click the menu button.
VoiceOver on, settings, row 2, column 3.
To turn VoiceOver on, and I can triple click it again to turn it off.
VoiceOver off.
Another way you can turn VoiceOver on is by using Siri on your remote. So you can hold down the Siri button and just say turn VoiceOver on. Turn VoiceOver on.
VoiceOver on. Settings. Row 2. Column 3.
And in the same way you can turn it off. Turn VoiceOver off.
VoiceOver off.
If you've used VoiceOver on an iOS device, you'll find using VoiceOver on the Apple TV to be very intuitive, and that's because you use many of the same gestures. For example, you can flick with one finger in any direction to move the VoiceOver cursor and change what is read aloud.
Search. Row 2. Column 4. Twit. TV. Row 3. Column 4. PBS. Row 3. Column 3. Settings. Row 2. Column 3.
To make a selection, you'll press on the touch area of the Siri remote, just as you would when VoiceOver is not turned on.
Settings. Settings. General. Button. 1 of 9.
And to go back, you'll press menu, again, just as you would when VoiceOver is not turned on.
Settings. Row 2. Column 3.
Just as with iOS devices, you can use the rotor to access other options. To use the rotor, you'll put two fingers on the touch area of the Siri remote, and you'll turn a virtual dial.
Characters. Words. Mute alerts. Speech rate.
Then when you hear your desired option is selected in the rotor, you can flick up or down with one finger to adjust the value of that setting. For example, here I'm going to adjust the speech rate.
40%, 35%, 40%.
To finish up this tutorial, there are a couple of other gestures that you may find helpful. The first allows you to read everything from the top of the screen. And what you'll do is take two fingers and then flick up on the touch area of the Siri remote.
Director, Pete Docter, starring Amy Poehler, Richard Kind.
And you can pause the speech by just tapping with two fingers in the touch area of your Siri remote. And if you tap again with two fingers, it'll resume speaking.
Bill Hader, Louis Black, Mindy Kaling.
And if you want to read from the currently selected item to the bottom of the screen, you can flick down with two fingers.
Inside Out, 2015. 1 hour, 35 minutes. Kids and Family, 2015. Rated PG.
Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to get more videos like this one on my YouTube channel. And also make sure to check out my website at luispérezonline.com and follow me on Twitter at _LuisFPerez.